In this screencast, we're going to operate a batch still using variable reflux to achieve a constant distillate composition. In the problem statement, we're giving the total number of equilibrium stages in the batch still unit. We're also told the composition and amount that's charged initially into the batch still unit, and we're told that we're going to run this operation until we get a given concentration in that reboiler at the end of the batch still operation. We're asked to determine how much distillate product is produced, and finally, the range of reflux ratios used. Now, the basic mode of operation in this particular batch still is to use the reflux ratio to adjust and basically compensate for the amount of separation that we're getting out of the column in this overall vapor liquid equilibrium process. So as the batch stills run, as we start to deplete the amount of ethanol in the total system, we can then increase that reflux ratio to still achieve the separation that's desired and also deliver the concentration of distillate that we're looking for. In most batch still operations, we use the Rayleigh equation to relate the composition in the reboiler and the composition of the distillate. But in this case, since the distillate composition is constant, it's effectively decoupled from the composition in the reboiler, so we don't necessarily have to use the Rayleigh equation. We can accomplish the material balances associated with this process simply with a more traditional what goes in, comes out type material balance that we've seen before. So in this system, we would just balance what goes into the system, which would be the number of moles of liquid initially charged into the reboiler, and balance that with what remains in the reboiler at the end, and that would be in the number of moles, and add to that the number of moles that emerge from the column and the form of distillate. So that gives us the total mole balance of the system, but we also have another piece of information, which is the component balance. So if we do a component balance about the ethanol in this system and see what goes in, specifically the number of moles of liquid initially charged to the system, the composition of that liquid going in, and we balance with that what comes out in terms of the number of moles of liquid remaining in the reboiler, the composition of that fluid, and then add to that the number of moles emerging as distillate and the average composition of that distillate. And in this case, since that distillate composition is constant, that's just the constant distillate composition in the problem statement. When we plug in the values from the problem statement, we see that we now have two equations and two unknowns, and we can solve those to determine the number of moles that remain in the reboiler at the end of the distillation operation, and also the number of moles that emerge as distillate, which was one of the questions we were looking for in the problem statement. And now we arrive at the second part of our problem, and that is to determine how we adjust our reflux to account for the changing composition of liquid in the reboiler. Since this is a distillation operation, the first thing we should do is look for the vapor liquid equilibrium data associated with that system. And then we're going to consider what's going on both at the beginning and the end of the distillation operation. So at the beginning of the distillation operation, we're going to first find an operating line that satisfies the system. And then based on what we know about that operating line, we're going to calculate the reflux ratio for that state. And we'll expand on what we mean by that a little later. And then we're going to do the exact same thing for the final state. So the first step in our plan is to get the vapor liquid equilibrium data. And I've done that for the ethanol water system, and we've pulled this out of Perry's. With that information in hand, we're now going to move to the second part of our plan and determine the operating line associated with the initial state and also calculate the reflux ratio. So we know a couple things about any operating line. Operating lines need to satisfy the points X is equal to Y is equal to your distillate composition, and for this case, that distillate composition is 0.6. Now, the operating line slope also, for this case, has to give us a bottoms composition, or in this case would be a waste composition, of 0.3, and it has to give us that composition with exactly two stages. So these are the pieces of information we need to put together to determine what operating line satisfies this condition. So we're going to go to a zoomed-in view of the vapor-liquid equilibrium data, and we know that we have the point X is equal to Y is equal to the distillate composition of 0.6, and we also know we need to satisfy the bottoms composition emerging out at 0.3. So we're going to satisfy one point and take a guess at what the slope might be. and step off the stages. So the first guess on slope is, hey, maybe that slope's 0.5. We don't particularly know right now, but we're going to take a guess and we're going to see what composition comes out of the bottom of the column with this particular slope. So I draw that operating line, and when I go step off the stages, we see that our bottom's composition associated with this slope or this operating line does not satisfy what we were looking for. We were looking for a bottom's composition of 0.3. So that's not going to work for us. So we're going to have to adjust our slope. Let's take another try and see if we're heading in the right direction. The new slope I'm going to try is a slope of 0.25. Step off the stages. We're still not quite there, but we're heading in the right direction. So we repeat this process several more times until we arrive with a slope that's approximately 0.125 that's going to give us two stages, and then we arrive at our bottom's composition or our waste composition of 0.3. So now that we have our operating line, we need to calculate the slope of that operating line. For this particular case, it's 0.125, and based on that slope, we can calculate a reflux ratio. So now we know when we start our distillation operation, we need to have a reflux ratio of
0.14
to deliver that final distillate composition of 0.6. But we also know as we run the distillation unit, the concentration of the liquid in the reboiler is going to decrease, so we're going to have to increase this reflux ratio to compensate. So what's the highest reflux ratio we might need in this particular distillation operation? Well, that's going to be the reflux ratio associated with the final state of the system, where we have a composition in the reboiler of 9% ethanol. So now we have to determine the operating line associated with this condition and then calculate the reflux ratio in this state. We use a similar process to what we used before, where we fix one end of our operating line to our distillate composition at the reference line and then adjust our slope to figure out what bottom's composition we get after two stages. We go ahead and do that through another guess and check process, and we arrive at a slope of 3/4 is going to give us the desired bottom's composition with only two stages. So with that slope, we can go through and calculate what our reflux ratio is, and we see at the high end we're going to need a reflux ratio of 3.